Hi, this is my psychology and film project over Finding Dory. So Dory is a fish who lived in the ocean throughout the movie, suffers from short-term memory loss. She had gotten separated from her parents as a child and throughout the movie had to continue to look for them. She traveled with Marlin and Nemo through the ocean, back to an aquarium, the Marine Life Institute, and finally found her parents as she remembered memories from her past. My diagnosis for Dory would be anterograde amnesia, and this is that type of memory loss which makes it hard to form new memories. It is a very rare condition which Dory suffers from in both Finding Nemo and Finding Dory, and I found out this from the Cleveland Clinic about anterograde amnesia. And if Dory went to a therapist, it'd be a little different since they are fish, and they would probably not have the education and know what type of amnesia it was, or even if it was amnesia, they would probably just say she has short-term memory loss, like Dory has said throughout the movie. So some of the stigmas related to the disease is just that countries with better education opportunities would be able to know that a character like Dory would have anterograde amnesia, and just countries with lower education opportunities may diagnose them as just having memory loss or may not know how it can be helped. Some cultures also do not treat people with disabilities the same way as like people in the United States do. They do respect them, but some countries like may mistreat them in like an unkind way and dismiss their diagnosis and just like believe they can't be helped. Some of the symptoms that Healthline helped me find was just Dory was very confused throughout the movie, and throughout the story was often confused at the task at hand and would get very easily distracted. She was confused about her past and often remembered things in a different way than they occurred in. And when she was on her journey to find her parents, she often would get distracted by people and other fish and other signs of the aquarium, which would make it actually harder for her to find her parents. And she had to constantly be reminded that she was on a journey to find her parents, and just had to be kept being retold that. Dory also had a trouble remembering past events, and Dory had forgotten a lot about her past with her parents, which made it difficult for them to find them. And throughout the movie, she started to remember more and more things that brought up past memories. As Dory started to see things at the Marine Life Institute that she remembered, it would bring up memories of her parents like she couldn't remember beforehand. For example, when she saw a purple shell, she had remembered that her parents said to always follow the purple shell to return back to them if she had ever gotten lost. So one symptom Dory doesn't show much is experiencing false memories. While she does get confused about her memories, things were not altered in them. When she did remember things, and it was very clear what her memories were. Treatment. There is currently not a treatment for anterograde amnesia, but some of the possible treatments like help prevent the underlying conditions, and some of the things you can do is like improving memory is to like retrain the brain and using compensating strategies like using a planner and keeping a diary. So the treatment I would use for Dory is just like procedural learning, and it focuses on repetition and practice and like learning things over and over again, and just also priming, which gives cues to help learning, and like eventually we'll need less and less cues to remember things. And Cleveland Clinic helps me a lot in finding this, and since Dory isn't a human, like some of the things like on computers and making notes wouldn't work in her setting that would work on a normal human character having anterograde amnesia. So some of the broader perspectives, I do believe that Dory was a pretty accurate portrayal of anterograde amnesia. Dory had most of the symptoms of having a hard time remembering new information, as she also slowly remembered things that she had cues to help her remember. Disorders in films can often alter our true understanding of what symptoms truly are and how this disorders affect people in their everyday lives. And while Dory was an accurate portrayal of anterograde amnesia, some films do not show the disorders correctly and may alter our true understanding of what these disorders are and how they do affect people. And here's my citations. Thank